everyone, I'm Samantha. I'm a meteorologist here at the National Weather Service in Seattle. So over the past few weeks, we've been creating videos about local weather phenomena. And so today I thought we would do a short informational video on Fraser outflow. So you guys are probably wondering what we're talking about when we say Fraser outflow. Well, we're referring to really strong northeasterly winds that are coming down through the gaps of the Fraser River Valley. So if we look at a map, and I've drawn a really nice map for you guys, we've got Washington here and we've got Canada up here. So what we can see is we've got mountains here to the north and south, the Cascades, and then we can see that we've got another mountain range up here extending into northwestern British Columbia. And so the Fraser River gap is right here. So it's kind of like this gap right in between the mountains. And so what this will do is it will allow strong northeasterly winds to funnel down into our northern counties. And so when I refer to our northern counties, I'm usually talking about Whatcom and Skagit County, and even the San Juan Islands. And so we can usually see, depending on the strength of the event, anywhere from 35 to 50 mile per hour winds, sometimes even 60 to 70 mile per hour wind gusts. So you can get really strong winds that can potentially blow down trees or power lines, things like that. So how do these events occur? So the first thing that we're going to look for is a high pressure system that's setting up across British Columbia or even interior Alberta. So that's going to fill this basin with cool, dense air. And the next thing, since we're looking for pressure gradients, is we're gonna wanna look for a low approaching Western Washington. And so let's say this low is approaching from the southwest. So as this low is approaching this high pressure up here, the pressure gradient is going to get tighter. And so air flows from high to low. So this is going to cause a surge of that cool, dense air through this gap. And as it goes through here, it's going to accelerate. So that's gonna cause really high wind speeds for areas like Whatcom, Skagit, and even the San Juans. So for the science geeks out there, this is actually the perfect example of the Bernoulli effect, but we're not gonna go into large details about that now. So what type of impacts can we see with Fraser outflow events? So the first one is strong winds. So as I mentioned earlier, you can see winds anywhere from 30 to 50 miles per hour, and this all kind of depends on the strength of the event. You can even get events with 60 to 70 mile per hour wind gusts up there. And so that will usually impact Whatcom, Skagit, and the San Juans. In addition to that, you can see really cool wind chills. I know we had an example earlier this year. We had a Fraser outflow event that created wind chills in the low 20s and the high teens. So it can get pretty cool as that cool, dense air is coming down southwestward through that gap. And then another example is snow. So anybody remember the snow events from February of 2019? Well, so in that case, we had a Fraser outflow event going on, and the winds actually reached the Olympic Peninsula. And so once it reaches the Olympic Peninsula and hits the Olympic Mountains, that wind has nowhere to go but up. And so once that happens, you have what we call upslope flow, and it created localized bands of snow, which led to over a foot of snow falling in areas like Squim and Port Angeles. All right, and with that, I would just like to wrap it up and say thank you guys all for tuning in. If you guys like these videos, please do let us know and let us know what type of weather phenomena you would like us to explain next. All right, stay safe, stay healthy. Have a good one, guys.